In the 2019 legislative session, the South Carolina General Assembly passed an amendment to the Youth Access to Tobacco Prevention Act to combat teen usage of e-cigarettes. Now lawmakers are looking to add more legislation to fight the same issue.
Every day you see a new report of a teenager who is experiencing these pulmonary and breathing issues.
Representative Beth Bernstein helped pass legislation in the most recent session to prevent teens from having access to tobacco products, including e-cigarettes.
Prevented those under 18 from purchasing vaping products, and also going into vape shops, and kind of made the system, online system of ordering, much more robust.
A recent increase in illness and deaths possibly linked to e-cigarettes prompted President Donald Trump to call for policy to ban flavored e-cigarettes. Representative Beth Bernstein wants similar legislation here at the state level.
97% of those teenagers are using the flavored products. So it's the flavored products which is enticing them.
Juul Labs, an e-cigarette company, has already stopped selling its non-tobacco, non-menthol-based products to retail stores. I was able to get a response from Juul Labs in relation to this legislation. The company says, "We strongly agree with the need for aggressive, category-wide action on flavored products, and the company will continue to combat youth usage." In Columbia, Georgia Godfrey, 7 News.
One thing to keep an eye on as we track whether the legislation Georgia is talking about will actually pass. Juul Labs, the e-cigarette company she was just talking about, is investing about $100 million, creating 500 jobs at a facility that is in the making in the Midlands.